we continue with our praise and worship. When I think of we continue our praise and worship, just meditate for a bit. We know the reason why we are here this morning, and our gospel reading is talk about we are the vine and Jesus is the branch. Right? So we have to bear fruits of good, love, peace in our hearts, forgiveness. We could only do that and love one another through the precious and divine blood of Jesus Christ. That is our only Redeemer, that is only our healing, that is only our answer to our problem. Give God praise. Brothers and sisters, open your mouth, sing. Praise God. Sing. Praise Him with a song, with an instrument, with dance, the clap. Whatever we give out, God wants His fire, because He gave us fire as the Holy Spirit. Give Him back that power, that fire. Whatever we give out is what we're going to receive. Brothers and sisters, let us praise God. And let us praise God with all our minds. As we continue with our praise and worship, Lord, I lift your name on high.
I'm so glad you came to save me.
You came from heaven to
Amen.
Let us please stand for entrance hymn. It's number 375 in the old, 377 in the new, 381 in the revised. Sing to the Lord a new song. 375, 377, 381.
Gathers a people of faith
believing and trusting in God that He hears and answers our prayers. Today's gospel invites us to remain rooted in Jesus. He's the vine, we are the branches. The branches must be connected to the vine in order to bear fruit that will last. And for the times that we have strayed from God, from the times we have failed to remain rooted in Jesus Christ, let us be sorry and ask pardon and mercy from Him. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves. Celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
O Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you are pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternally. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul got to Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him. They could not believe that he was really a disciple. Barnabas, however, took charge of him, introduced him to the apostles, and explained how the Lord had appeared to Saul and spoken to him on his journey, and how he had preached boldly at Damascus in the name of Jesus. Saul now started to go wrong with them in Jerusalem, preaching fearlessly in the name of the Lord. But after he had spoken to Hellenists and argued with them, they became determined to kill him. When the brothers knew, they took him to Caesarea and sent him off from there to Tarsus. The churches throughout Judea, Galilee, and Samaria were now left in peace, building themselves up, living in the fear of the Lord, and filled with consolation of the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord. The response, "You, Lord, are my praise in the great assembly." My vows I will pay before those who fear him. The poor shall eat and shall have their fill. They shall praise the Lord, those who seek him. May their hearts live forever and ever. All the earth shall remember and return to the Lord. All families of the nations worship before him. They shall worship him, all the mighty of the earth. Before him shall bow, and all who go down to the dust. And my soul shall live for him. My children serve him. They shall tell of the Lord to generations yet to come. Declare his faithfulness to peoples yet unborn. These things the Lord has done.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. John. My children, our love is not to be just words or mere talk, but something real and active. Only by this can we be certain that we are the children of the truth and be able to quieten our conscience in his presence, whatever accusations that may rise against us. Because God is greater than our conscience, and he knows everything. My dear people, if we cannot be condemned by our own conscience, we need not be afraid in God's presence. And whatever we ask of him, we shall receive, because we keep his commandments and live the kind of life that he wants. His commandments are these: that we believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and that we love one another as he told us to. Whoever keeps his commandments lives in God, and God lives in him. We know that he lives in us by the Spirit that he has given us, the word of the Lord.
So last week, we had Jesus presenting himself to us as the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd who lays down his life for his sheep. Like Jesus, today I'm presenting myself as the Good Shepherd who is willing to lay down my life for my sheep. Because as good shepherds, we need to seek the interests of those in our care. We need to look after them. We need to take care of them. And in so doing, the enemy would always attack the shepherd. If we get rid of the shepherd, the sheep scatters. So that was last week. This week we have Jesus presenting himself as the vine. I am the vine and my Father is the vine dresser. I am the vine and you are the branches. I am the vine and you are the branches. In other words, when Jesus is the vine and we are the branches, we must be part. And so the heart of every Christian community is the presence And so living without the vine will produce, living within the vine will produce abundantly. If we live with the vine, within the vine, if we are connected to the vine and we remain rooted in the vine, we will produce abundantly. However, if we separate ourselves from the vine, we are a withered, rejected bunch, which can do nothing. A withered, rejected bunch, who can do nothing. And so we need to ask ourselves, as branches, are we connected with the vine? And if we are connected with the vine, are we producing fruit? Are we producing fruit? And if we're producing fruit, what kind of fruit are we producing? Because if, as a vine, if we are connected to the vine as branches, and we are not producing fruit, will be cut off and thrown in the fire. And what kind of fruits are we producing? Jesus reminds us in Scripture and said to his disciples, "By their fruits you shall, know them. By their fruits you shall know them." So the kind of fruits we produce, people will know who we are. As Christians, what we produce is how people would identify us as. As Christians, we are called to be rooted in the Spirit, which helps us to produce fruits. And what are the fruits of the Spirit that we are called to produce? What are the fruits of the Spirit? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Right? These are the fruits of the Spirit that we are called to produce. And let us examine ourselves as Christians and see if we are producing those fruits. Are these fruits part of who? Are these fruits of the Spirit part of the community in which we belong? For us, saying good shepherd, are these fruits present in our community of good shepherd? Are these fruits present in our parish, St. Dominic? Are these fruits present in our diocese, the Diocese of St. George's in Grenada? Jesus reminds us that if we are not producing these fruits, if we are not producing fruit, we will be cut off and thrown in the fire. And so for those of us who are not producing, who are non-productive, will be cut off and thrown in the fire. And there are a lot of us who are non-productive. A lot of us as Christians who are non-productive. A lot of us in this parish are non-productive. And we're not producing fruit. Or if we are producing fruit, certainly not the fruits of the Spirit. But we are producing fruits of the devil, of the enemy. And so it's either we produce fruits or we are thrown in the fire. And St. Augustine captures this very well in either the vine or the fire. Either the vine or the fire. It can be in between. It's up to you and to me and me to determine either we're in the vine or the fire. And so as a Christian community, the commandment that binds together this community is twofold: to believe in Jesus and to love one another as he commanded us. To believe in Jesus and to love one another as he has commanded us. And when we follow this command of Jesus, the commandments of Jesus, especially those that lead us to faith and love, but all of them leads to love, we are at peace before him. We are at peace with ourselves. We are restless. St. Augustine reminds us, says our hearts are restless until it rests in the deep. So when we rest, when our hearts rest in God, then it will be at peace. My dear brothers and sisters, such a community of love and faith is possible. It is possible. Although some of us say, well, it's hard to live in love and to live in peace and faith and all of that. But it is possible. And Luke's Gospel assures us that through all Judea, Galilee, Samaria, the church was at peace. Sorry, it was not Luke's Gospel, but Luke's writing. That all through Galilee, Judea, and Samaria, the church was at peace. And that peace, my dear friends, is in the church today. But oftentimes you and I erode that peace by our actions. We erode that peace by our actions. And wherever we sow seeds of division, we erode that peace. And there are a lot of us in the church. I don't know about you in the chapel, but there are a lot of us in this church, in this diocese, that sow seeds of division. And when we do that, we erode the peace that is in the church. So for many of us, because of what we are enjoying today, for a lot of us, because of what we can get out of certain situations, we erode the peace in the church. But it's only during the course of the week, a press conference with a few journalists that the Prime Minister had. And I happened to be scrolling on Facebook just around that time to get part of it. And then I only made a statement, and after that I switched off. Because I said he's out of place. I switched off. So he was, some question they asked him was in regards to the vaccine. And he would have said that he's calling on the churches to play their part in promoting the vaccine. He went on to say, and clearly it was an attack, and not just churches, but the Catholic Church and a few of us priests. He went on to say that the Pope would have vaccine and I would have encouraged the Catholic Church to take it. He went on to say that the bishop would have taken it. However, he said that he knows of some priests who are encouraging people not to take the vaccine. And he's calling on the bishop, in other words, to deal with them. Calling on the bishop to deal with them. And the last time I checked, my dear friends, the church was not part of the government. The church is not a ministry of the government. And for the prime minister to utter such nonsense is out of place. It's out of place. And I know that when I make statements like that, or these statements when I make it in the church, I know it gets back to him. I know that. And that is why it says that as Christians in the church, we are eroding the peace that is in the church. Because when we do that, what are we creating? So as priests, we must not speak out about social issues in the church. And who want to speak, who want to remain mute, good for them. Good for them. As long as I see issues affecting the lives of the people, I'm going to talk about it. Whether it's on the pulpit, whether out there, I am going to talk about it. I ain't here, and I ain't free. So when they lock me up, Miss Mitchell, don't come and quote for me. Don't come and quote for me. Let me go in jail. Okay? Because I cannot understand how, as Christians, you're coming to church to worship God. And you're taking what is said in church and bringing it to the politicians. To do what? To create division. Why are we doing that? Because we're eating our food? And usually, the people are doing that and think they're eating our food. What they're getting is the scraps in the barrel. Amen. That's what they're getting. The scraps in the barrel. How can we operate like that as Christians? To have the prime minister in a press conference attacking priests. He's calling on the bishop to deal with them. My dear friends, Jesus, in today's gospel, is inviting us to remain in him, the vine. But in order for us to be connected to the vine, we must live in love and peace with one another. We cannot sow seeds of division. We cannot turn a blind eye to injustice. We cannot turn a blind eye to victimization and remain connected to the vine. We'll be cut off and we'll be thrown in the fire. I may end up in the fire too. But I think some of us would end up there before. Some would end up there before me. My dear friends, that peace which you are invited to live in, that peace which Luke says is possible because the church before lived in peace, it is possible for us. But in order for us to achieve it, we need to stop the nonsense. We cannot achieve that peace when we are maligning each other. And a lot of us, we do it for selfishness. As I said, what we can get out of it festival. Number of persons died. Stampede. Chaos everywhere. And so, if we live in a world where there is no peace, who is called upon to bring peace in the world? Isn't it the church? The church, my dear friends. But in order for the church to speak of peace in the world, it has to be at peace itself. The church has to be a peaceful community. And who are the church? Who is the church? Not the world. All of us. You and I. We are the church. And in order for us to bring peace to the world, we must be at peace ourselves. Must be at peace. We live in a church where, from top to bottom, all of us fighting. From top to bottom, fighting. And what are we fighting for? Power. That's what we're fighting for, power. And so there must be that faith and resilience, there must be that faith in and reliance on Jesus, and there must also be that love for one another. So we must have faith in Jesus. We must have that reliance on Jesus. And we must have love for one another. We ought to remain connected to the vine. Who is the vine? Jesus. Jesus. As church, the world must be able to look at us and say, we are at peace. We are at peace. But if we are not giving them that idea and that impression, they would never look at us and say, we are at peace. Only when, as church, we are at peace with ourselves. Only when we as individuals are at peace with ourselves. Only then we can bring that peace to the world. Only then we can bring that peace to others. Only then. In the Synod of Bishops held in 1971 on justice in the world, the church fathers had this to say. It says, that the church may really be the sign of that solidarity which the family of nations desires. It should show in its own life greater cooperation between the churches of the rich and the poor regions through spiritual communion and divisions of human and material resources. Only then. That as church, within ourselves, we are called to collaborate more, to bring that equity between richer and poorer nations, to ensure that the richer nations does not exploit the poor nations. And if we are to take it outside of nations, we're looking at it at individuals, that the rich does not exploit the poor. That the politicians does not exploit the poor and the vulnerable in our society. And if as church, we cannot speak about these issues, who will? Like St. Augustine, ut vitus, ut illis. Either the vine or the fire. Either the vine or the fire. It's up to you and I. not will be in fire, because we are not producing. So as Christians, let us ask ourselves, am I producing fruit? If I'm producing fruit, what kind of fruit am I producing? What kind of fruit am I producing? Let us now stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, but substantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Trusting in God that he hears and answers our prayers. Let us continue asking him for our needs and the needs of one another, saying, Lord, make us authentic disciples.
Lord, make us authentic disciples.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this day and ask you, Lord, to purge us from all our wickedness, all our sins, O Lord. We need your cleansing this morning, O Lord. Our nation, our people have gone astray as sheep. Bring us back to you, O Lord, as you are our good shepherd. Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Father, we thank you for the gift of life and the sonship that you have bestowed on us. We have the opportunity of being alive and fruit-bearing branches by being attached to our Master and Lord Jesus, your Son. Give us the grace that we may not abandon these precious gifts that you have given us out of your bountiful love. We ask this and all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our sacrificial offering, I'm sorry, it's not in the praise of the Lord, a little loving. To our visitors, we have a welcome collection. The basket is placed in front of the altar.
Sacrifice and yours May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant we pray that we may come to know your truth. We may make it ours by our way of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just as you can our salvation. At all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to Lord you are more glorious, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with pastoral joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers of the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all issues, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other thank you. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul
Our post communion hymn is number 120 in the Old, 118 in the Revised, no, 351 in the Revised. 120 in the Old, 118 in the New, 351 in the Revised. My God bless you. 120, 118, 351.
Band of Marriage, Second Calling between Michael Duncan of Wall St. John and Pauline Ferguson of Pembroke St. David. If anyone knows of any reason or reasons why this couple should not be joined in holy matrimony, please contact the Cathedral Administrator on 440-2999. You should speak now or forever hold your peace. Next Sunday is the beginning of our Marian pilgrimage to Our Lady of Fatima, starting at 3 p.m. It will be broadcasted live on GNCC. We would also like to thank all those who contributed and participated in the brunch last Sunday, and also the children who sang last Sunday. Catholic Engage Encounter Couples Retreat will be held on May 14th to 16th at Mountain Elders Retreat Center. This is for couples in steady relationships or those who are planning marriage. The cost is $400. If you are interested, you can contact Ellis and Sabrina on 442-6973. Is there anyone celebrating birthday today or this week?
I offer these two people to you. that you should bless them as they did the meeting last week. Please come forward. And I shall stand with them for a second blessing.
I think Mr. Andrew did that in spite so that he can get more blessings. Father God, we thank you for members of this church committee that you could have done a blessing. This was a meeting. We thank you, God, for and their continued service as they will be part of the transition. Thank you for the continued service. We thank you for the yes, to serving this community. And we pray that you would bless the work that they would embark on behalf of this community, that it would be a fruit that will last, fruit for your kingdom. As you bless them, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So we have spoken about the effort that we are making to towards our brothers and sisters in St. Vincent. So only during the course of the week, we shipped a container of stuff. We were able to get part of the problem is us the transportation from here to St. Vincent. The diocese doesn't want a boat ride, so sometimes we have to depend on other entities, and I think we were able to get a container, I think, on this boat, which also cost us a fortune. Okay, because if we ship it on the boat, we have to pay. Alright, so we got a container off, and we had one other container. One of our other brothers and sisters separated from us. They were shipping some stuff as well the following day, I think. They didn't have enough to pull a container. So we are able to get some stuff in their container to our brothers and sisters. And even before the week, we would have shipped a number of items up to St. Vincent. Now information reaching us is that they do not need water. Right? Too much. And that reminds me after Ivan. You know, after Ivan, I stopped eating condiments. Because I was seeing too much condiments in my eyes. So they have too much water. Food, from all indication, they are not doing too bad with food. They have food in the supermarkets. The problem is, in the immediate evacuation, those places are closed. So once things begin to open up, we do not need to send them food. They have food. We might be able to send them some agricultural produce because that is destroyed. However, people's lives are also destroyed.